The rally brought in supporters and sympathizers from as far as Omega in the Muke constituency and Nkurenkuru in the Kavango West region. DTA presidential candidate McHenry Venani explained that all the party's promises contained in the manifesto is implementable. Venani says his party is the only party that can bring about the needed change in the country, particularly on job creation for the young people. He pointed out that the DTA believes that the future of Namibia lies in the hands of the young people and their potential needs to be nurtured and harnessed.
A lot of the members of the media are asking, where is Venani going to get this money? In South Africa, they have initiated a youth venture capital program. In India, they have a youth venture capital program giving businesses to young people. In Kenya, in Cambodia, in Brazil, our manifesto is one of the manifestos that is costed and budgeted.
The youthful presidential candidate also noted food security through harnessing agriculture in the two Kavango regions to make them the breadbasket of the country.
Why can't we initiate a program where we avail people to have more bigger lands and fence them off free of charge so that we make sure that if you plant your mahangu or you plant your maize, that produce will be to the benefit of our country.
In local authority areas of the two Kavango regions, if voted into power, the DTA will lower and subsidize water so that it becomes affordable for the poor people because they cannot pay high bills as the river from where the water is tapped is just next to towns. On land in towns, the DTA will give land to people through the urban resettlement scheme by giving the land free of charge to live on. Francisca Thikereti, NBC News, Rundu.